Hey there, welcome to this Data Science Dojo video tutorial on automating the tasks of web scraping for analyzing text. In this video tutorial, we'll be web scraping for text analysis periodically. There are many applications that require text analysis on recent or timely content, or capturing changing events and commentary, or analyzing trends in real time, and so on. As fun as it is to do an academic exercise of web scraping for one-off analysis, it's not useful when wanting to use timely or frequently updated data. So I'll take you through the process of writing standard web scraping commands in R, filtering timely data based on time diffs, analyzing and summarizing key information in the text, and sending an email alert of the results of your analysis. Then in part 2, I'll show you how to automate running your script every hour or periodically so you can run this in the background of your computer and free yourself to work on more interesting tasks. So let's imagine you would like to tap into new sources to analyze the events happening in Bitcoin or in any other area that frequently changes by the hour. These events could be analyzed to summarize the key changes or movements in Bitcoin, rate the overall sentiment of recent discussions, capture important events, and so on. So you need a collection of recent Bitcoin events or news scraped every hour so that you can analyze these events. We're going to use MarketWatch's Bitcoin articles as an example data source, but it can be any other news website or any other topic area. If you check out our blog tutorial link below this video, you'll see an example of using Reddit to scrape political news and events every hour. However, just keep in mind whenever using a repository such as Reddit, it's easy to filter pages that were published within a time frame as they're usually marked as published X hours ago or X minutes ago. But when you're dealing with dates in different time zones, it's not that simple, so we'll also tackle this problem in this video tutorial. So let's start with a quick demonstration of scraping the main head and body text of a single web page just to get familiar with the basic commands. We're going to use the library Arvest for this, so if you just uncomment this and run this, you'll install this library here. This also applies to all other libraries that we're going to use in the tutorial. And don't forget to load it into R. So we're just going to scrape a single web page. So if we look at our example page here, we're just going to use this one here as an example. So copy that URL, and we're going to call it MarketWatch web page, and we're going to use the read HTML function, and we're going to feed it our data source. Okay, great. Now that we've read in our data source, we want to scrape the title of the web page. So how do we get the title? We basically look at the source code and search for the title text. Bitcoin jumps. So as you can see, the title lies within the title tags. So what this means is the program's going to search for the title tags and then grab everything in between these tags. So let's go ahead and write this. So we'll refer to our source. And we want to look for the HTML node called title. And we want to grab the text. Okay, great. Now when we run this command, it should output the title of the web page. So let's go ahead and do this. And as you can see, it successfully grabbed the title. Now what we want to do is grab the body. So the body text usually lies within the paragraph tags of a web page. So we're going to write a similar command here. MarketWatch web page, and we want to get all nodes or all instances of the paragraph tag, and we want to grab the text. Okay, great. When we run this command, we should get all the text that lie within all paragraph tags. So let's go ahead and run this. And I'll show you up here. Okay, great. Looks like we grabbed all the body text that was lying within these paragraph tags. Now that we've had a quick play, let's get right into it. So we're going to read in our source. Our source in this case is just going to basically be a search results page of everything on Bitcoin recently published. So let's go ahead and run this. Okay, great. Now we want to get the URLs on this web page. So our URLs are our articles, and they basically lie within this specific div tag here. And we also want to get the href attribute. So we don't want to get the text per se. We want to get the href attribute for our URLs. So let's go ahead and run this. And let's check our URLs. Okay, great. As you can see, there's 15 URLs or 15 news articles that we're interested in. Now we want to get the published date times of these news articles. And depending on the time of day, some of them are made invisible and some of them are not. So let's go ahead and check this. Okay, it looks like they're all visible now. So what we're going to do is modify this code a little bit. We're just going to get rid of invisible. I'm going to rerun this. Okay, great. We have all our 15 date times. If this was made invisible, what we would do is run two commands and join the invisible and visible date times together. Now what we need to do is treat these date times accordingly. So we need to clean them up a bit, we need to convert them into standard date time formats, and we also need to take time differences. So a good package to do all these kind of tasks is called Lubridate. It's designed for this kind of thing. So we're going to install and load this into R. Okay, great. So as you can see here, Lubridate finds it difficult to interpret AM and PM with periods in them. So what we need to do is basically remove these to make it easier for Lubridate to understand AM and PM. So we're just going to remove it by replacing it with an empty string. So let's go ahead and run this command. And now it's ready to pass into the pass date time function. So this is going to create a standard date time format. It just makes it easier to work with later when it's in a standard date time format. So let's go ahead and do this. And we'll have a look at it. Okay, great. Now all our date times are in standard date time formats. Now, before we go further, let's have a look at our example article here. You can see that all the articles are published with Eastern Standard Time. But what if we're not in Eastern Standard Time? What we're going to do is take time differences between the date time of the article and our current time. So it's going to be difficult for us to do those differences if we're working in different time zones. So what we need to do is take these date times, and we're going to first ask for it in Eastern Time. And then we're going to ask for it to can be converted into our local time. And in my case, it's US Pacific time. So let's go ahead and run these. And let's have a look at the converted date times. Okay, great. Everything's in Pacific time. Now we need to create a data frame. So we have our date times here and we have our web page URLs that we grabbed before. Now we're just going to stick them into a data frame, one column called web page, another column called date time. So let's go ahead and run this. And we should have 15 rows with two columns, and let's check this is the case. And it is. Now we're going to create another column in our data frame called diff hours. And we're basically going to take our current time or our system time and compare it with the date time that the article was published. And we want to get the differences in hours. You can get it in minutes or another unit measure, but we're just interested in hours. So let's go ahead and run this. And let's have a look at our differences. Okay, great. Now, it's not clear whether these are in their proper double data types. So let's just make sure they're treated as a proper data double type here. Let's go ahead and run this command. And let's have a look at it. Okay, great. They're treated as doubles now, which is what we need. Now that we've got these values, we're going to create a column and stick them in diff hours. Going to add it to our data frame. So let's go ahead and run this command. Now that we've got our data frame of web page URLs, we've got the date times and the differences in hours, we're going to use these differences in hours to subset them down to everything that was published, say, 1 hour ago or 2 hours ago, or however long you would like it. So in my case, I'm just interested in everything that happened, say, 7 hours ago. So what we're going to do is look at everything that was published, or a date difference of less than 7 hours ago, and basically filter these rows down to the ones we're interested in. So let's go ahead and run this. And let's have a look at it. Okay, so we got one article that was published within 7 hours ago. So what we're going to do now is take this filtered list or this new data frame with the filtered web pages. We're going to read them. We're going to grab the title of each web page, and we're going to grab all the paragraph tags and collapse them into a single body and place them into their respective titles and body vectors. So let's go ahead and run this. And now we're going to add all the titles into the title column of our data frame, and we're going to do the same with bodies. So let's go ahead and run these. Okay, great. Now if we have a look at all the names, all the column names of our data set, we should see a more complete data set. Okay, great. So we've got the web page URL, we've got the date time, we've got the differences in hours, we've got the title, we've got the body. What we're going to do is just inspect the body text a little bit more. So this is what we're going to use to analyze or summarize on later. So if we have any major issues here, we want to know that now rather than later when we're ready to analyze it. So let's just have a look at this. And we'll just look at the first case. Well, we've only got one case anyway. Okay. As you can see here, there's a few problems with the text. So we've got these random new lines, carriage returns, we've got random white space happening here. So this is going to make it difficult to analyze on when the text has a bit of problems. So what we're going to do is just clean out the major junk. We're not going to go too far into cleaning in sense of, you know, normalizing the text by lowercasing it, removing stop words, etc. We're just going to get rid of all the obvious junk. So a good package to do all this is called Stringer. So let's install and load this into R. And we're going to use this function here just to get rid of all the major junk in the text. So those new lines, carriage returns, random white space, etc. And we're going to apply that onto the body. So let's go ahead and run this. And let's have a look at our text to make sure it's clean. Okay, great. Did a pretty good job at cleaning it up. So got rid of all those major problems there. It's going to make it easier for us to summarize on later. Okay, in this part of the tutorial, we're actually ready to summarize the text. So we're going to use LSAFund library, which uses a simple ranking algorithm to summarize the text. But there are more sophisticated ways to summarize text and extract key information. Other types of analysis can be done on the body or the title text, and Data Science Dojo Bootcamp covers text analytics and how to write programs to make sense of text if you want to take this further. But in the meantime, we're just going to use a simple summarizer. So what we're going to do is loop through each body text and grab the top three sentences with the most relevant information. So the most relevant in terms of having the most keywords, the most information-rich sentences, and then we're going to stick it into its respective summary vector. So let's go ahead and run this. First of all, we need to install and load the library. And let's have a look at our summary here, or summaries if we had more than one case. Okay, great. So now we have a much more condensed version of the text. So when I email this to myself later, I don't have to email the entire body text of the article. I just want to get like a quick snapshot of the key events that happened in this article and not have to read the entire thing. So what we're going to do now is add it to our data frame, and we're going to put it under a column called Summary. So let's go ahead and do this. Now, basically ready to email it to ourselves. So we're going to use this library here. We'll install and load that into R. This is basically going to allow us to email text to ourselves. Now, I could simply take the data frame and email that to myself, but I'm going to go a bit beyond that. I'm only really interested in the title and the summary from this data frame. So what I'm going to do is create a vector that prints things in certain order. So I want it to print it in the order of title 1 followed by summary 1, then title 2 followed by summary 2, and so on and so forth. So let's run this code here so we can have things that print in order. And let's just check it does print it in order. So let's have a look at this. Okay, great. So the body of my email is going to have the title, followed by the summary. And if there was more than one case, it would be title two followed by summary two and so on. Okay, now we're ready to set up the parameters. These are the parameters that we're going to input into this function here to send our email. So we've got the from email, the to email, the subject line. We've got the body text, which is going to be our titles and summaries. And we've also, if you're using Gmail, you want to specify Google's SMPT. You could also have more than one email you could send it to, so you can create a vector or a list of emails here. But for the purpose of demonstration, I'm just going to send it to myself. So let's run these. Okay, great. When you see this here, you know that it's successfully sent. And here's one that basically just sent to myself not too long ago. We've got the title of the article followed by the body. And basically this gives me a nifty little snapshot of everything that happened in the Bitcoin world in the last few hours or so. Thanks for watching. In the next part of this video tutorial, I'll show you how to run your script hourly so you can automate this process even further. If you found this video useful, give us a like. You can also check out other videos at Data Science Dojo Tutorials.